Hello, my name's George Cairns, and in this video lesson I'm going to show you some compositing tips, tricks and techniques using Photoshop CS6 to take this chap in the studio background here and isolate him, select him and transplant him into a surreal landscape scene complete with floating umbrellas. So let's kick off by opening Surreal before 01.dng, and that's a digital negative file, so it's going to open up in the camera raw editor and we can process our background. The first thing we'll do is crop it and then we'll tweak the colors and tones. It's worth cropping first of all because then you don't have to worry about the colors and tones in the bits you're not going to use. So let's click here on the crop tool and choose the 1:1 to give us a square crop window. Then we can click and drag around about here and that will give us a nice square shape. We're just going to lose a little bit of the end there. You can then drag the crop window around and just fine-tune things to get the ocean looking like this. So we're just using this section here and losing these greyed out areas in the crop shield. Click on any other tool to apply the crop. You can always go back to it and fine-tune things at any time because it's non-destructive editing, and we're now ready to tweak the tones in the right-hand side here in the basic tab. Now the histogram doesn't look too shabby, there's a nice spread of tones there, but we can just brighten things up a little bit by going to exposure and dragging that to the right to boost it up to about 0.65 just to create a brighter looking shot. We can also then tweak the highlights as well, claw back any missing highlight information by dragging this slider to the left to about minus 89 or so should do the trick. You can always type in a value in the wee box there. Next thing to do is to just tweak the clarity because there's some delicate mid-tones in the sky here, so we push that up to the right. That just creates a higher mid-tone contrast and reveals some subtle tonal detail, so around about plus 17 should do the trick there. And I'm just going to boost the colour as well, or the vibrance rather, to about 35, and that will just give us a little bit more kick in the colours. We're going to create a monochrome version later on, but more vibrant colour still gives us more contrast and texture detail. So once you're happy, we can then click Open Image to open our cropped and tweaked image into the standard Photoshop editor, like so. And you can see there's a nice contrast range with some dark shadows, some mid-tone detail and some bright highlights. Next thing to do is to go to File, Open and browse to our next start image, which is Surreal before 02, and that's a DNG file, a digital negative, so again it'll open up first of all in the camera raw and we can create a nice high contrast scene because you can see there's not much shadow detail in the histogram, so it's really going to stand out if you add him to that much higher contrast background. So what we need to do is improve his contrast first of all, and the best place to do that is in camera raw. So let's pop to the contrast slider and type in a value of 20 to create a better contrast between the blacks and whites. We've also got lots of mid-tone detail here, so we can take the clarity slider to the right to increase mid-tone contrast to about plus 30. And again, you can see there's the before, very washed out. There's the after, there's a bit more contrast there now, and the blacks are looking a bit blacker. We can tweak those specifically by taking the black slider to minus 26, and that gives us some darker pixels that will match the darker ripples in the water in our background image. Click Open Image to take the shot into the standard Photoshop editor. Now, as there's lots of contrast between the background and the chap, we can use the trusty Magic Wand tool to make a quick and effective selection. Set the sample size to 3x3 average, just to spread it out a little bit from a single pixel. Go to tolerance of 20 and tick contiguous so it doesn't select too much of the similar colours inside the chap's outline, like these white cuffs here. Then just click to start making a selection of the background, like so. You'll then need to hold down the shift key to get this little plus icon and add any missing bits to the selection, like the areas around his feet, maybe these bits of shadows as well, and then control or command plus to zoom in a wee bit, press the space bar and drag with the hand tool to have a look at areas that you may need to recover, and we'll grab this tool here, which is the quick selection tool, and we'll just subtract it from the selection by clicking and spraying, and then that helps bring his collar back from the selected area. If need be, go back to the magic wand and shift click to add these little bits to the selection. You'll find that down here it's a very similar tip to the background there, so you need to go back again to the quick selection tool and we're going to subtract that from the selection, hopefully by clicking and dragging like so, and then it's going to calculate this little area here. That's not too bad, there's a little bit of a dint here, so what we can do is just go back to add to selection and just click and spray at the very edge there just to fine tune things, and that should shape up quite nicely. There we go. And once you've finished refining the selected areas, like adding this little bit down here to the selection, you're ready to go to select, choose inverse, and now the figure is selected instead of the background. Now, if we copied the guy and pasted him into the seascape, you'd probably see some white pixels still clinging to his outline, and it would be quite jaggy as well. So we need to pop up to Refine Edge to get a better edge to our selection. So let's click to get the zoom tool, and let's just click and drag to zoom in for a closer look at the edge, and 100% should give us the best idea of the quality of the selection. You can see that some white pixels are quite jaggy, so let's take the smooth slider up to 15, and that will dramatically smooth that selection very, very quickly and easily. That looks much better already. We can also soften the edge by typing in a value of 1 for feather, and that helps the guy's pixels blend more effectively with the pixels on the background image layer when we add the two together later on. We can also do things like decontaminate these white colours clinging from the background there by ticking here and setting this up to around about 70 or 80%. 70 is probably good enough, and that automatically then gives us a new layer with a layer mask when we apply the changes. And finally, if there's still any background pixels clinging there, you can take Shift Edge to the left to around about minus 18 or so, and that will just tighten the selection around the edge there and get rid of any remaining white background pixels. So once you've made these fine tunings, then let's click OK to create our new layer with a layer mask. And you can see we've got a soft, smooth selection with no white background pixels clinging to the edge of our chap. Pop up to Window and then go to Arrange and choose Tile All vertically to see the two shots side by side. Click on the layer, drag it to the new document to add the chap to the landscape scene. And then what we can do is go back to Window, Arrange, and this time Consolidate All to Tab just to see this shot here. Control minus a couple of times just to zoom out. Command or Control T gives you the transform window, and then you can either click and drag to scale it down or type in a width of 50%. Make sure you tick the little chain there, and that will also create a 50% height as well. Hit return to apply the change, and then the move tool enables us to place the chap on the beach in a position just before the water's rippling at his feet. Now, I don't know if you can see that clearly, but there's actually a white line around the edge of the figure, and that's the edge of the black bit of the layer mask. So grab the brush tool, make sure you're clicking on the mask, make sure this is a black brush, not a white one. You can click here to toggle them around, and if you click and spray, that will get rid of that telltale white line around the edge of the chap. Once you've finished tidying up the mask, click here to select the chap and press Command or Control J to duplicate the layer. Then pop up to Edit, go down to Transform, and flip it vertically to create a mirror image, which we'll then place below the main layer. Grab the Move tool. You might need to untick Auto Select so you can make sure you've got the right layer selected, and then just drag it down below until the tip of the umbrella is just about touching and the feet are overlapping slightly, and that should do the trick for our reflection. Now, the reflection looks too sharp and clear, so what we need to do is click on the layer mask, grab the brush tool, choose a nice soft brush of 200, set the opacity to around about 30%, and then just click and spray black on the mask to just soften the reflection. Once you've covered that whole area once, spray a little bit more down here to make these top areas of the legs even more semi-transparent as they begin to fade away from the slightly sharper and clearer ones down the bottom there. So something like that should give you a subtle but realistic looking reflection. And to anchor the guy even more, what we're going to do is click here to create a new layer, and we'll just grab the brush tool, keep it on black, keep it on 28 to 30%, and we'll just quickly just spray in a soft hint of shadow under the boots on those settings there, and again under here as well, just to add a little bit more grounding to that part of the image, like so. And then Z for the zoom tool, right click, fit on screen, and you can see it's beginning to shape up nicely. To add a sense of mystery and atmosphere, let's click here to create a new layer. Let's grab the gradient tool by clicking here, pop up to the gradient editor and choose foreground to transparent. Click OK and then choose the reflected gradient option up here. Then click on the horizon, hold the shift key and draw down to around about the tip of the brolly, let go, and that will create a nice reflected gradient that gives you this lovely mist effect. And make sure that's behind the man's layer and all the other layers as well, so we can just drag it down to just above the background layer like so. And then we can just reduce the opacity a wee bit just to reveal a little bit more of the wave texture and a hint of the horizon, so around about 90% or so should do the trick there. Now scroll up to the top of the layer stack, click on here, and then click here to add a new adjustment layer. We're going to go for black and white. And the cool thing about this is we can then darken particular colours, like the blues in the skies. If we take this to the left, you'll see that the skies get darker and the clouds pop out more on a value of about minus 84. There's also some cyans in the sky as well, so if we drag this left as well, we'll darken the cyans around about minus 24 or so. Will give us a more dramatic contrast there in our monochrome conversion. To create a more dramatic vignette where we darken the corners, we're going to click here to create a new transparent layer, and then we're going to edit fill that with 50% grey by clicking here, choosing grey from the drop down there like so. And if we then go and change the blending mode to overlay, then you can't see any of the grey at all at this stage until we darken some of the edges, and these edges will see darkening the corners of the shot. And to do that, we're going to use a filter. We're going to go for lens correction, because that's got a vignette correction option which you can also use creatively to actually darken the corners. So let me just fit that in the window like so, and then what we're going to do is go to custom, and we're going to go down to vignette amount, and if we drag this to the left, we can darken the corners of the shot, as you can see here. And because of the overlay blending mode, we'll only see these darker pixels appear. So let's click OK, and there you'll see that we've got darker corners at the edge of our frame. Let me just turn that on and off so you can see the before and the after, and that just adds a bit of mood and drama to the shot. Now at this stage we've got a totally black and white image, but just to add a slight warmth to the black and white, we're going to go and add a new adjustment layer. We're going to go for photo filter this time, and we're going to use a nice yellow like so, and set that down to around about 20%, just for a more subtle but slightly warm tint. Use the same techniques we used to select the man to isolate the umbrella from its white studio background, and then you'll have a layer mask there hiding most of the umbrella's white background. You can then click on the mask, grab the brush tool, set the brush to black, and then click and spray to hide the supporting clamp like so. We'll just spray over that. Now once you've finished tidying up the layer mask to get rid of any of the clamp and surrounding edges, then what we need to do is right click on the layer mask and choose apply layer mask until it's just the umbrella against a transparent background. Then Z for the zoom tool, and then click and drag to zoom in for a closer look at this missing gap here. And what we're going to do is grab the clone stamp tool by clicking here, and then set the size to about 90, and then alt click to sample just in the center like so, with this reflective bit. And as you move down, what you can do then is align the preview overlay, click and drag to extend the umbrella over the gap like so. You can then add the umbrella to the main project as a separate layer and place it below the black and white adjustment layer, and use Command T to get the free transform up and scale it down by about 28% so it fits into the screen like so. And then you can drag and duplicate it, grab the move tool here, and then just shove that over into another position, Command T or Control T to get the free transform tool, and then scale it down to make a more distant one. Make sure you hold shift to constrain it, otherwise it'll squash or stretch, and then you can place that floating away into the distance like so. So we take that down again to a smaller size and just hit return to apply the change. And then to make it look more distant, we simply just drag the opacity down to around about 90% or so, so that the shadows are slightly lighter than those in the foreground, because these ones here are being diffused by particles of mist in the air. And once you've fine-tuned the position of this brolly, duplicate it and then transform it down and reduce its opacity a wee bit more to create the more distant umbrella. And as a finishing touch, we can zoom in for a close look at the chap's main layer, click on the layer mask, and you might see a little bit of white background there clinging to the edge. So what we can do is grab the brush tool, choose a nice soft edge brush, choose a nice black foreground colour, and then if you click and hold shift and click again, it will draw a straight line between the two points. And that's a cool way of spraying black on the mask, just to help hide the edge of any remaining white backgrounds clinging to the edge of the chap. I can do it again here on the shoe, click, shift click, and it draws a straight line of black between the two points. I can also move around the edge and just reduce any remaining white lines. That's just a cool way of tidying things up, thanks to the non-destructive power of layer masks. So Z for the zoom tool, right click, fit on screen, and there is our edited shot.